everybody knows. Not only high, it's very high. My living is a taxi driver, so I have to buy gas every single day. Because of that, my income is coming down by, makes a difference about 5 to 10 pounds a day difference with what I buy. So that means my income is down, and I reduced my movement, you know. I used to drive my family to different places. Because of the gas price now, we stopped driving and we reduced where we're going. So I think it affects my life in another way. If you want to reduce the gas price, everybody has to stop buying gas for a few days, or, you know, to stop. At least if everybody stop buying gas once a week or 2 days a week, so maybe these people, they'll panic and they start reducing the price. Because we know that they can afford to reduce the price. They can afford it, but they need more profit, so they can't do it. So to force them, probably, I mean, to organize things and stop buying it.
Well, I take the bus and the tube usually, like almost every day, because that's the cheapest option for me. The gasoline price is quite expensive in London and actually in the whole Europe. The tube is still expensive, but at least that's fast and you don't have to get stuck in the traffic jam, you don't have to worry about these things. If the lines are working, that's nice. So I take the bus and the train every day to get to work.
There are a number of different reasons for why the fuel price in the UK is significantly higher than the rest of Europe and the US. The main reason is probably because of the tax in the UK. So the tax in the UK, you've got various different taxes which apply to fuel, such as fuel duty and VAT, and when they get added on top of the base rate of fuel, it makes the price which is added to the consumer quite a lot higher. So because the price of VAT has gone up recently and the fuel duty has gone up recently as well, the overall demand in the UK for fuel has actually reduced a little bit over the last couple of months. In addition to that, you've got the problems in the Middle East, and which are affecting the supply of fuel, such as in Libya, Tunisia and Syria, which is spreading across the Middle East and causing prices to rise, and OPEC, who are withholding the price of fuel, and that's also contributing. Well, OPEC, who are holding the price of fuel and increasing the price of fuel per barrel, which is causing the price to increase. So all in all, these different variable factors are causing the whole price of fuel in the UK to rise to like an inaffordable rate to like normal consumers. Obviously, fuel is quite a vital resource that has effects on all other aspects of the market. So price in retail, prices are increasing. Transport costs, likewise in the food market, prices are going up as well. So all of these things together mean like the UK consumers and as individuals are less well off as those in the EU and those in the US as well.